I wonder, what is a mammal? Oh, hi, I'm Kaden. Welcome to Smithsonian's National Zoo and Conservation Biology Institute, where I've been wondering, what makes a mammal a mammal? Let's go explore the zoo and find out. Come on. So what do you think? What is a mammal? I'm a mammal, and so are you. Mammals belong to a group of animals that all have some of the same features. Can you think of things that all mammals might have in common? Mammals are usually recognized for their fur or hair, which is quite different than having feathers or scales. Mammals are vertebrates, meaning they all have a backbone. Mammals are endothermic, which means that they generate their own body heat through the food that they eat. Mammals give birth to live babies and feed their young with milk. And mammals use lungs to breathe in air, just like you and me. Now, thinking about those traits, can you think of animals that are mammals? Let's go rumble through the zoo to visit our largest mammal, the largest one to live on land. Do you know what mammal we'll see? The largest land mammal is the elephant. There are two species of elephants. Here we have Asian elephants, and there's even a bigger species called African elephants. Now, we said that mammals have hair or fur. And elephants are mammals, so where's their hair? Not all mammals are super hairy. Elephants are covered in a lot of little hairs, so they might be hard to see from far away. But you can see them easily where they're most concentrated, like their ears, their head, their chin, and even their tail. Now, can you think of any animals that have a lot of hair? There are so many mammals with a ton of hair. Sloth bears are one of my favorites. All right, let's move through the zoo to one of my favorite black and white animals. Which mammal do you think it is? This is Maggie, our Holstein heifer. She has hair and she is a mammal. Mammals come in many different shapes and sizes, but all of their bodies include bones just like ours. If you feel the bones up and down the center of your back, that is your backbone. And Maggie has a backbone too. Now, our backbone is our spine and it contains lots of vertebrae. A backbone is important for support, so each mammal's backbone is adapted to suit their needs. Maggie's backbone is built to be super strong to support her big body. Now let's move along to meet another animal in the park, one of our cutest and newest additions. Which mammal baby do you think we'll see? One of the newest additions to the National Zoo is six-month-old Zara. Zara is a lowland gorilla, and she is a mammal. She has hair, vertebrae, and her mother, Kalea, birthed her. While animals like birds lay eggs, most mammals give birth to live young. Mammals feed their young through milk made in the mammary gland, which all mammals have. This is a big characteristic that gives the group mammals their name. Now, gorillas don't swim, but there are some mammals that will swim even as babies. Can you think of any mammals that spend a lot of time in water? Did you think of any mammals that can swim? I like to swim. How about you? We also have otters and our California sea lions that are behind us that love to swim. Now, sea lions, they have hair, they have vertebrae, they give live birth, and they come out and swim every day, even if it's cold, because they are able to stay warm. That is because mammals are endothermic, meaning their bodies work to keep a constant temperature on the inside, even if it's cold outside. They generate body heat through the food they eat. And my friends back here love to eat fish and squid to give them heat and energy. Marine mammals also have a really cool special layer of fat called blubber, and that acts like a winter jacket to keep them warm in this chilly water. Now, what are your favorite things to eat that give your body energy? These are American bison, Lucy and Gally. Bison roam the American Great Plains where they get their energy from eating grasses and other plants. Now, have you ever been outside and it's been so cold that you can see your breath? Maybe you can see mine. On cold winter days, you can often see Lucy and Gally breathing. Mammals breathe using lungs. We inhale oxygen into our lungs and we exhale carbon dioxide. What are your favorite things about being a mammal? Wow, that was a great question to explore and answer together. There are so many cool traits that make mammals mammals. I personally love being endothermic, being able to eat food to give me energy and help me stay warm. Now, there are many different mammals that live in habitats all over the world. How can we help keep mammals happy and healthy? We can help by protecting their habitats. I help by making sure their habitats are clean. I pick up litter anytime I am out observing animals around me because a clean habitat is a healthy habitat. Now, I also look for places where maybe I can expand their habitat, give them more food or shelter by planting a native tree or wildflowers. There are lots of things you can do. What will you do to help the animals around you? Now, I love asking questions and wondering about animals. How about you? Do you have something that you're wondering about? Ask your question, go find your answer, and learn a lot of cool stuff along the way. Ask an adult to help, and they can learn along with you. Thanks for wondering, exploring, and learning with me. I'll see you next time.